Fly FM.
This is Hafiz, this is Gibo, this is RD, and we're from Malaysia on a radio station called Fly FM.
Nice to meet you guys. Good to talk to you.
Nice to meet you too. Okay, so let's get this started. In the movie, you actually play a character by the name of Frank. He's a cop, right? And he likes to bend the rules just a little bit. Are you similar to Frank in a way?
I mean, am I similar in a way? I've never committed a crime and never broken the law. And you're right. Yeah, I play a cop who he's not supposed to be taking this pill, and he does take it. This is a pill that can give you superpowers, but you don't know what power you're going to get. It could be something incredible, or it could be terrible. It could kill you right away. And I think Frank, you know, on the one hand, he loves his city and he's doing his best to try to protect the people of New Orleans. But on the other hand, he is guilty of temptation. He just wants to see what that power is, you know? So he's a human. And I relate to him in that way, that he's not perfect. I definitely am not perfect. And, you know, I do my best and I make mistakes and I'm, you know, weak at times and I try to be strong other times. I think that's really all you can do as a human being. We're not heroes. We're not gods. And that's just who people really are.
Right. Yeah. So Frank, being a rule breaker, I'm sure you've broken some rules. Could be a house rules, family rules growing up, anything like that.
Taking the car out.
Yeah. I mean, I'm sure at some point or another. Yeah. I mean, look, I just took a couple years off acting. That's kind of against the rules in Hollywood. You don't usually take time off. It's looked down upon. You're like, what about your career? What about your momentum? This town is all about heat, blah, 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 blah. Yeah. And I felt just, look, I'm having kids and I'm lucky that I can afford to take time off. And not everybody is fortunate enough to have that opportunity and I'm going to take it. And so I did. And it's been since 2016 since I was in a movie. And certainly a lot of people and even just voices in my own head were like, oh no, are they going to forget about me? You know, is it going to be okay? But, you know, luckily I was able to, you know, start it back up again. I'm in 3 movies this year. Project Power is one of them. Nice. And happy to be back.
Great to have you back, man, because again, you're one of my favorite.
If you could choose only one, what favorite power would you choose from the movie?
There's one guy in the movie, he's camouflaged. He's not quite invisible, but he can camouflage himself. So he's, for all intents and purposes, invisible. Right. And I mean, I like that idea because I like observing, you know, I like going places and just watching to see who's doing what. What's happening. And sometimes if you're not invisible, you can't always observe exactly what would happen if I wasn't there, you know?
Right. Yeah.
But if I could be camouflaged and just go to places and see like what's really happening, behind closed doors, or what's really happening with these, you know, I don't know, in places that I wouldn't normally get to go to, or if I did go there, I would attract a lot of attention and people wouldn't be, you know, themselves around me.
Yeah.
I don't know. So that would maybe be a cool power from the movie. I like that you made it from the movie. Everybody's been asking me, what would your power be if you could choose a power? But you guys put a twist on it. I like that. Like,
we got some sad news though, because we talked to Rodrigo and he already chose that power. So you got to find something else.
No, damn.
That's me. He wants to be invisible with Rodrigo.
But he said the exact same thing. That's
exactly
crazy.
The same thing.
Really? That's so funny. Yeah. I did not know that. I have not heard him say that. No, we're similar people, I guess. Rodrigo, incredible actor.
Yes.
For sure. Yeah. So off camera, how was it like working with Jamie, Dominique, and also Rodrigo? Do you guys like have something?
I mean, Jamie Foxx is an icon. He's a legend. You know, I mean, I've looked up to him and laughed at his comedy and then just been so drawn into all of his performances over the years. I remember in Living Color back in the late 80s, you know, and Ray, his performances, Ray Charles, I mean, is another level. And then Django Unchained, one of my favorite Tarantino movies. So I could go on. Jamie Foxx is just incredible. But really, we should talk about DominiqueFishback, because if you guys are fans of movies and actors and actresses, you should watch this movie, if for no other reason than to check out Dominique Fishback. This is a young artist who has a long career ahead of her, I'm sure. She's brilliant, just honest, dedicated actress. And I can't wait to see what she does next. I'm so much fun working with her.
Nice.
Well, that's the time we have with you, Joseph. Thank you so much, man.
Yeah, Malaysia. Yeah, thank you guys.
Please come. It's really great to meet you. Rock.
Have a good one.
You too. Take care.
Bye.
Fly FM, today's hottest music.